prepare to be boarded.
Big hits! Goodbye. But...
Well now.
What? But...
Now listen here.
Mm-hmm.
Master Evan? Oh, it is you! It really is! Raja? Gosh, it's been so long. How are you? Relieved to have found you, that's how. The guards were all talking about how you'd been spotted. Oh, I was petrified they might get to you first. You mustn't stay here any longer. King Mausinger has ordered your arrest.
Thank you for your concern. But I came here to speak with him, as one ruler to another. I mean to forge a union between our two kingdoms.
And how do you plan to do that? In case you haven't noticed, the borders are closed, and the entire country is cut off from the rest of the world.
I know, but... Can I ask you something, Ratcha? Is Ding Dong Dell better now? Are the rats and mice happy?
I think I know what's bothering you, but there's no need to worry, my dear. King Mausinger will come to his senses. He always hated injustice. That's why your father put his faith in him in the first place.
Really?
Oh yes, because he felt the same. And that's why he gave Mousefolk a chance, like no king of Ding Dong Dell had ever done before. Well, he made me his maid, didn't he? And Mausinger his chancellor. Such things were unheard of at the time.
But Mausinger believes that... He believes that my father simply used him in order to keep Mousekind under control.
Does he indeed? Then he's sorely mistaken. Your father, near enough, pulled his mane out trying to build bridges between our two peoples. It's just a shame you have to take an old maid's word for it. If only he could have told you himself. His diary would have been the next best thing, I suppose, but I'm afraid they laid it to rest alongside him.
Is that right? Thank you, Ratcha. You've been very helpful.
Glad to be of service, my dear. Just you be careful now, you hear?
Hey.
Well now. Thank you.
Good luck, everyone!
Do you remember the day I made you my Chancellor, Mausinger? The other ministers,
were up in arms, but they dare not say so to my face. I trusted in you. I could see the resolve in your eyes, the determination. You yearned to bury the differences between our kinds, just as I did. I trust in you still. I know that you will continue what we have started, and that you will succeed.
Thank you. Oi!
Golly! Oh, come on!
Oh my!
Greetings.
Excuse me.
Ha!
Oh no.
King Mausinger, please, we have to stop this before it's too late. I see now why you overthrew me. So much has happened between our two kinds. But we can't let it go on. We have to bring the hatred between our peoples to an end.
And what would you know of hatred, boy? Of the taste of shame, of the humiliation of servitude. The line of the Tildrums ends here, today, at my hand. Oh, how long I have waited for this. Ding Dong Dell will never be yours! Never! Come, Tildrum! Time to meet your fate!
Who's next?
humiliated by two generations of the same accursed line. Damn you, Tildrum, and all your kind!
We don't have to do this, Mausinger. I didn't come here to fight you. I don't want to fight you!
Come, Your Majesty. You cannot simply bow to defeat. If you do not destroy these worms, our people will never be safe. They will never be free!
Free? Yes! We must be free!
But not like this! Don't listen to him!
Every last Grimalkin must die! Come, Oakenheart! Come to me! My Gingsbon! Who are you?
I had thought this tedium would never end.
At last it is done, Master!
Vermeen!
I hope you can forgive me, Your Majesty. Even I must confess to feeling some small pang of guilt at having encouraged you to slay your dearest friend and patron. But you should not have so readily taken my word over King Leonard's. Those who claim that blood runs thicker than water grossly overstate the case, my beloved fellow mouse.
No!
In truth, your precious king was too nauseatingly good-natured to betray you, to contemplate anything so base as manipulating you into keeping our kind in check. And more fool him, as you are so very easy to manipulate.
Vermeen, how could you?
How could I betray my master? How could you be so foolish as to ask such a question? And now, Lord Doloran, I have fulfilled my part of the bargain. My price was the kingdom, if you recall. I hereby claim it.
Yes, of course. You must be rewarded for your faithful service.
Doloran, what have you done to him?
I have repaid the debt of a traitor, and not a moment too soon. This accursed kingdom, not only was its ruler too pure-hearted to succumb to my corruption, even his closest aide proved immune to my advances. In the end, I was forced to settle for this contemptible worm. I have wasted so much precious time. But at last, my plan is complete. What a pity you will not be present to witness its glorious fruition!
Oakenheart! Has it really come to this?
Wait! You needn't do this alone! We'll fight him together!
Thank you.
ourselves useful!
No!
It says...
He believed in me. And I... What have I done?
Mausinger. My dearest friend.
Your Majesty, I...
Be still, Mausinger. I forgive you. Our two kinds have borne each other ill will since time immemorial. The rift between us could not be healed so easily. It was a distance that could only ever be closed one step at a time. But close it shall. One day, we will stand together, hand in hand at last, all thoughts of oppression consigned to history. And you, Mausinger, you will bring this about.
But, Your Majesty, why would you... Why would you trust in one who had failed you so utterly? And whose hand you...
I always trusted you, old friend. And I always will. You see far, further than I ever could. You are a maker of plans, a doer of deeds, a true ruler. Yet there remains in you a lingering shadow of doubt. Doubt in others, born of doubt in yourself. A king must learn to trust his own judgment.
A king? You mean that you still think me worthy?
Who better to rule over the realm I love than one who loves it just as fiercely?
If it please you. Your Majesty.
It does. And now, I must be on my way. When next we meet, I would have you tell me the tale of a kingdom made great by its wise and benevolent ruler.
Yes, Your Majesty.
Farewell, Mousinger. I leave Ding Dong Dell in your hands. Do not fail me. Become a true king. Watch over the land we both love so well.
I will not fail you, old friend.
King Mousinger. I humbly propose that a pact be made between our realms. Will you sign the Declaration of Interdependence?
It is what your father would have wanted. For our two kingdoms to stand as one. And so it shall be.
Thank you, Your Majesty. Let us work together to make a better, more peaceful world.
You have come far, son of Leonard. I will gladly stand beside you. And I will make Ding Dong Dell a kingdom where all races can stand beside one another. The enmity of generations will divide us no longer. I salute you, Evan, Lord of Evermore.
Thank you. Nations be joined for the sake of the world.
Let the banners of war ne'er again be unfurled.
United we stand as one single land.
Sure enough, Ding Dong Dell began to change from that day forth. No longer did Catkind cower beneath the ground in fear of tyranny. Instead, the Grimalkin stepped out into the sun and saw their brother mice as if for the first time. And the hatred that had divided them for so long melted away like so much snow. Well, perhaps not entirely, but these things take time.
The declaration's finished, Evan. You did it.
And we made peace with Mausinger too, which is something. But his king's bond was stolen, and Dolaran really does mean to resurrect the Horned One.
So what if he does? You'll be ready to face him. You'll overcome this trial, just like all the others. After all, if you can as good as unite the whole world, you can do anything!
You're right.
But it's not over yet. And this last part isn't going to be easy.
The time has come. All four King's Bonds belong to me. At last, I shall have my heart's desire.